You knew there was a what if hanging over this Cotton Bowl. What if Ohio State had made the college football playoff after a 24-7 win over USC in which nobody scored in the final 32 minutes? Can Ohio State fans Bill Landis make a case that, hey, the Buckeyes should have been in the playoff?
No, I feel like this in a weird way should like make you feel better about things. And I feel bad because they came here to win a bowl game, and they won a bowl game, and they finished their season with a win, and that's all you could do when you came here to Dallas. Frankly, it didn't really matter how it happened, as long as it happened, and it happened. But if you were angry at all about Ohio State not making the playoff and thinking, man, we should have got a shot because I thought we could have done something there, I thought that this was a little bit of proof that that probably wasn't the case because this is a flawed football team. They didn't score for the final 35 minutes and really had a hard time moving it on offense the entire game against a USC defense that is frankly not that good. Ohio State's defensive line was awesome. We knew they were awesome, and they proved it, and those guys are going to the NFL on a high note. But I think Ohio State showed you like everything that was wrong with it this year. I think it kind of perfectly encapsulated the season. So great win, great to finish the season on a win, but I think validation that Ohio State did not belong in the playoff.
And again, we've made comparisons to the 2015 season and that Notre Dame bowl win in the Fiesta Bowl. That game felt more like you look at them and saying, man, they really are one of the four best teams. I just don't think you could look here. This was 5-8. I don't think anyone could have looked at this game and said that either of these teams were one of the four best teams in the country. So, you know, I think that defensive line made life really hard on a really good quarterback. And I was really wrong on this game because I thought Sam Darnold was going to do a lot of things. USC outgained Ohio State by more than 100 yards, but there were a lot of turnovers, 3 fumbles and an interception. They sacked him 8 times, and again, that's not him as much as a really bad offensive line for USC. So it was dominating, but I didn't feel like the offense like shut it down because they were ahead. I just felt like the offense wasn't really going to do much more than it did, and it got at least 14 points off turnovers. One was a pick six. Another one was set up by a fumble recovery that made like a 20-yard field.
All three of their touchdowns were set up by turnovers, and then they had a field goal.
This was not an offense that I think was going to march 80 yards at any point, and it never did. So, it's like you said, it's a win. It's a 12-2 season, but I think this was what it was, and what it was a team that was a half step short in a lot of ways. I think maybe we thought it would be better, but I do not think either of us believed this was a case made. It's a bowl game won, and you can't take those for granted. This was not a case made. And the Buckeyes finished 12-2, and that's pretty good. He's Bill. I'm Doug. Lots of an off-season stuff. Lots of off-season stuff. We don't stop. Do you stop, Bill Landis?
No, I'm very excited about off-season stuff.
It's going to be fun. He's Bill. I'm Doug. We'll see you then.